what to see, what to stream, and what to skip. It's Movie Reviews with Ryan J.
We absolutely love it when Ryan J tells us to see it or skip it, but today he's only going to tell us what's worth streaming since theaters are closed. And you are going to love how he looks right now because he is just kicking back. He's got his quarantini there, it looks like.
Are you wearing like casual pants with a shirt and tie?
Oh, yeah. I'm professional film critic on the top and pajama bottoms on the bottom. You know, we got to show these kids how to spring break right. I am home alone. I got my vodka delivered, ladies.
You've got a virtual happy hour going in the morning and your own quarantini.
If you're drunk, does it really matter if you're at a beach or at home? Let's be honest.
Great point.
And don't go to the beach, right? Stay here.
Exactly.
Stay home and pretend it's a beach.
Oh my gosh. Thanks for joining us this morning.
You always look great, right? Even when you're at home with your pajama bottoms on. I noticed the vacation socks there. They're looking good. Hey, do you want to say happy birthday to somebody?
Yes, I want to wish a very happy 100th birthday to my grandmother, Fritzy Suker. Her birthday was yesterday. Of course, we didn't get to see her, but we did FaceTime. It was fantastic. And there you can see I am with her at Thanksgiving time with my cousin, Melissa Dorf. Melissa and I channeled our David from Schitt's Creek in our black and white sweaters.
But oh,
I love you,
great.
Nani. Happy 100. You're beautiful. And here's the next 100.
Happy 100. Nani. That's so cute. I
wish I
love
you could spend
that.
It with her, but I'm glad that you could FaceTime and send her the well wishes. So
yeah, absolutely.
Happy birthday to her. Okay, let's get to some things that people can stream because people are looking for ways to stay entertained at home and they certainly want to watch things. So the first thing is Little Fires Everywhere. This is Hulu, right?
You guys, this is my new obsession. This was based on a novel by Celeste Ng, who, if you remember in January, Carol Barrowman on your show recommended everybody read
the
for
best
this.
Intentions.
It is so incredible, and it's just my new obsession.
So cool. Okay, so who are the stars in it? Who are you loving?
Well, this co-stars and is produced by both Reese Witherspoon and Kerry Washington. They prove themselves to be an amazing dream team. So different than what they've been doing recently from like The Morning Show or Scandal. And I swear they're both going to tie for winning Best Actress at the Emmys and Golden Globes this year.
Wow. How does the movie climax? What happens throughout the story?
Well, this is a TV series. We've got the first three episodes so far. In episode two, it's like revolutionary television. So amazing. Episode three, something happened that literally made me almost fall off the couch. It's that incredible.
So still a lot more to see with this one?
Yeah, there's five more episodes coming out each every Wednesday on Hulu, and you don't want to miss it. I mean, this is draw.
Ooh, it's a Little Fires Everywhere.
So
okay.
It's a stream it. I love it. Thank you so much. All right, let's talk about Spenser Confidential. This is on Netflix, right?
Right, yeah, this is Netflix, and this is a really great cop drama, and it stars Mark Wahlberg, who is in his element here. It's Boston. He's an ex-con cop who's recently released, and he's wanting to kind of right the wrongs in all the corruption between the police force and the politicians in that city.
Okay, so Mark Wahlberg, anyone else in the cast that's noteworthy?
Yeah, Post Malone making a great acting debut. We've also got Winston Duke from Black Panther. And let me tell you about Liza Schlesinger. She is a supporting actress in this film. She takes what is really a small role, probably on the page. She's so well-defined in this character. It's like that she steals the show. She turns it and makes it feel like a much bigger role.
Okay,
maybe the best.
What you don't know, Ryan, is she's one of my favorite comedians. I've watched all of her stand-up. She's hilarious.
She slays in this movie. You're going to love her.
Oh, my gosh. So when you're done watching that movie or that show, then you've got to stream her as a comedian because she is so, so funny. Her newest stuff is her best stuff.
Ooh, I'm so excited. Thank you for letting me know and all of us.
You will absolutely love it. So is this kind of a suspense, though? Like, it seemed moody.
It is suspenseful. There are a lot of dogs in it. It's like a mystery, a thriller. It's very rated R. The action is incredible. I want there to be a sequel. As soon as it ended, I was like, this should be a franchise. See Spenser Confidential on Netflix.
All right, I'm going to see it just because I love Liza so much.
Yeah. All right, let's talk about Stargirl. This is on Disney Plus, right?
Right. This was the one that Nicole Kidman told me to watch.
Ooh.
Oh, your BFF, Nicole?
Yeah, you can see there she posted on her Instagram story that she loved this film, and so I wanted to check it out, and it's on Disney Plus.
Who's the girl?
The girl is Grace VanderWaal, who won America's Got Talent, one of the seasons of America's Got Talent. She's a great YouTube performer. She's 16, and this film really displays all of her incredible charms and gifts. She's so talented.
I love it. Okay, so definitely stream it. Let's move to All the Bright Places on Netflix.
Mm-hmm. This is a teenage angst show. So it's a film that's got Elle Fanning from Maleficent. It also has Kelly O'Hara, who won a Tony Award for Best Actress in a musical, Luke Wilson as her parents. It's the good kind of cry. You feel everything that they're going through. And it's like different than Stargirl, which is a high schooler that's more of a feel-good musical movie for the kids. All the Bright Places is more TVMA and a little bit more mature for teenagers.
Oh, I like that. The good kind of cry. So that one's a stream it as well?
Yes.
Oh, I love
that. They're all streamers. These are all good ones to see.
Okay. Do you want to say something about what's going on Tuesday?
Yeah, I'll be back with you guys on Tuesday. I'm thrilled to be sharing with you all of the greatest family films you've never seen.
Ooh, I like that. That's good. Yeah. What a nice
tease.
There you go, Ryan. Hit it out of the park.
All right.
You go. Yeah.
Thank you, Ryan. Enjoy your quarantini.
You too, thanks.
We'll do a little conference call later. How about that?
I plan on it.
I love it. All right, you can like Ryan J on Facebook, follow him on Instagram and Twitter, and for his full movie reviews, check out his website. It is ryanjreviews.com. Hitting it out of the park from home today for
us. That's right.